Hey guys, welcome to my channel. This is AK Valia and today we're gonna have a face-off. The contenders of the face-off are Zoom versus Teams, and in the end of the video I will announce the winner of this face-off, and the winner will get more users, hopefully people who are watching this video. So Zoom and Teams, Microsoft Teams, are two softwares which are being increasingly used by people for remote collaboration and online meetings. And the way we will proceed is very simple. What I have done is to compare these two softwares. I have made a table and I will compare these two softwares, which are Zoom and Microsoft Teams, across a host of different factors. And we will pick out at the end of the video a winner amongst these two softwares. So the first factor that I want to talk about is ease of access and the user experience. For Zoom, there is no account needed. You can access the Zoom meeting via a simple URL or a Zoom ID. It has all the major integrations supported and it is super easy to use. As far as Microsoft Teams is concerned, it is a little difficult to use because it has a lot of features, an account is needed, and integration wise, it has a native integration with the Microsoft stack, such as Microsoft PowerPoint, Excel, Outlook, and so on. The next factor that I want to talk about is functionality. Zoom is a very function-rich software and has different functions, like you can support up to 100 members in a single call. You have a call recording function. In the call, you have an HD video. You have a whiteboard and screen share feature. You have different annotation tools through which you can collaborate and add notes to a meeting. This annotation tool is for participants and the host. You also have breakout rooms and a virtual background. Big breakout rooms help you, especially when you're a teacher who is teaching online and you want to divide up the students into small groups for collaborating on a group project, or you are a colleague who is or you're a person who wants to do some online training and you'd want to divide up the attendees into some groups. A virtual background is an important feature and a useful feature if your background is always messy like mine. So what you can do is you can just in a few simple clicks change your background and make it look more professional. Zoom also has a lot of collaborative tools, like you can raise your hands, you can chat privately with other attendees, you can view all attendees in a single grid, you can view up to 49 attendees, which is called the gallery view. You can join the Zoom meeting by a simple telephone. You can do this by a number which is provided with every Zoom meeting, and you can join that Zoom meeting by dialing in that number. You can screen share simultaneously if two people want to share the screen and explain something, and a remote control feature where you can gain access of another attendee's computer. As far as Teams, it is a more holistic software with a video call functionality, a chat functionality, a call functionality. You also have screen sharing, call recording, and blur background. Blur background is different from a virtual background, as in it blurs your surroundings and the focus is only on you. So it offers the same functionality as virtual background in Zoom, but offers it in a slightly different way. A very useful feature for Teams is transcription. So let's say, for example, you are having a call which involves people of different nationalities. And let's say you're having a call with someone who is in your team and is from the Germany office. So while that person is speaking in German and you have activated the transcription feature, what he's speaking will be shown to you, will be transcribed to English, and will be shown to you on the bottom of your screen so that you can understand what the person is exactly speaking. So this transcription is a very useful functionality. Apart from that, you can share files. There's a lot of add-on features or tools that you can add on to Microsoft Teams to improve your efficiency and effectiveness of using Microsoft Teams. And you can also organize very effectively on Microsoft Teams because it has a channel-based search functionality, so that you can organize and separate all of your meetings and all of your topics or projects into channels. And then if you want to search any channel, you can just search that channel name and all of that channel contents will be available to you. So in functionality, both Microsoft Teams and Zoom have a tie, but it depends on the function that you're using it for. In the ease of access and user experience, I would say that Zoom is a clear winner because of its ease of access and its super intuitive user experience and interface. Now we'll talk about the video quality. For Zoom, the video quality is good. You have an option of HD video and audio, which is excellent if you only want to use the tool for video conferencing. And for Microsoft Teams, the video quality is also good, but you don't have an HD video. But I have used Microsoft Teams and the video is at par with the Zoom video quality. If you talk about the pricing, both Zoom and Microsoft Teams, they have free versions, and you can upgrade yourself by paying a little, and that adds a host of other functions to your application as well. So for the basic upgraded version of Zoom, you pay $20 a month, and this adds a no time limit functionality to your software. In the free version of Zoom, you only have a time limit of 40 minutes for any meeting. You can access all features in that, but you can only access those features and the meeting for 40 minutes. And if you pay $20 for a month to Zoom, the time limit is removed. For Teams, it is a little expensive with $5 per member per month. You have to annually commit to that. And as many members as you have in Teams, you'll be charged $5 times those many members. And so Microsoft Teams is a little more expensive. Coming to security, Zoom doesn't have such good security because it has been facing issues like Zoom bombings, with a recent spike in Zoom meetings and people using Zoom. There has been a lot of issues like acquisitions of data being used by advertisers like Facebook, and Zoom bombings and malware associated with the Zoom software. And so the security is average. For Microsoft Teams, the security is good because it is a product of Microsoft, so it has enterprise-grade security and it is definitely more secure than Zoom. So for pricing, Zoom is the winner, and for security, Microsoft Teams takes the edge. Now this has been a very close battle, and the verdict. Now who wins? Now I would say no one is a clear winner because it actually depends on what you're using the software for. And if you're using it for, let's say, function A, I would say Zoom is the winner. And if you're using it for a function B, then I would say Microsoft Teams is the winner. Now, what are these functions A and B? Let's start with Zoom. So Zoom has some pros and cons. The pros are it is super easy and intuitive to use. It is the best software for video conferencing because it has HD video and audio, and there are rarely any freezes or connection interrupts. It is the best software for online teaching because It has a lot of collaborative tools like raising hands, breakout rooms, gallery view, and so on and so forth. It is perfectly suited for medium and large organizations, as the very basic version of Zoom also has up to 100 attendees in a meeting. And it is best for external collaborations, as you do not need an account to use Zoom. The cons of Zoom are the security issues that we just talked about. But if you want to use Zoom, if you are using it for online teaching or only for video conferencing or just for the fact that it is super easy and intuitive to use, you can make your Zoom meeting more secure by following some steps. I have given a comprehensive list of those steps that you can follow to make your Zoom meetings more secure, and they are available on the top right hand of the screen. And if you will click on that, you can find a list of comprehensive ways in which you can make your meetings more secure. Now let's come to Microsoft Teams. Like Zoom, Microsoft Teams also has some pros and cons. The pros are it is a holistic software having a chat, call, and video functionality. It is very secure, and it has a native integration with Microsoft apps such as PowerPoint, Excel, and Outlook, which makes it an excellent tool for organizations who have already invested in Microsoft Teams. And so I would suggest, if you're an organization and you are already using Microsoft Teams, then it is better to keep using that instead of switching to Zoom. It is best for internal collaborations, and if the main work for using Teams or Teams is collaborating internally and doing remote meetings within the organization, then Microsoft Teams is the best suited software. The cons are it is a little expensive than Zoom, and it is hard to figure out and use. And once you get used to it, then you can keep using Microsoft Teams very easily. So to summarize the whole discussion, if you're a teacher, if you want to do teaching, if you only want to do video conferencing, and if you want a software that is super easy to use, then go for Zoom. And if you are an organization who has already invested in Teams, if you only want to do internal collaboration, and if you want a really secure software, then go for Microsoft Teams. If you like the content, please subscribe and hit the bell notification icon so that you can keep updated with the videos that I am posting. If you have any difficulties in using Zoom or Teams, check out my channel where I have posted a lot of videos on tutorials on Zoom and Microsoft Teams separately. And please give me some love, guys. Share this video if you found this useful, and hit the subscribe button. Stay safe, signing off.